ओके, आई एम स्टार्टिंग देन।
हेलो प्रीतम दास, यू कैन स्टार्ट द प्रेजेंटेशन नाउ।
ओके ओके, थैंक यू। तो वंस अगेन, आई एम प्रीतम दास। आई एम परसुइंग माय एमबीए कोर्स फ्रॉम पोंडिचेरी यूनिवर्सिटी। सो आई एम वेरी ग्लैड टू बी ए पार्ट ऑफ दिस, एंड आई एम थैंकिंग टू एवरीवन हु इज organizing this and giving me opportunity for this. So my topic is research work on impact of COVID-19 on Indian economy and ways it can revive itself. So I am starting my presentation. So I want to say the abstract of my that research report. It will explain all the things. So as I said earlier, two lines, I am saying again. The outbreak of the COVID-19 pandemic is an unprecedented shock to Indian economy. The economy was already in a recession, as we all know. And for this effect of COVID-19, prolonged countrywide lockdown, global economic downturn, and associated disruption of demand and supply chains, the economy is likely to face a protected period of slowdown. So the magnitude of the economic impact will depend upon the duration and the severity of the health crisis, the duration of the lockdown, and the manner in which the situation unfolds once the lockdown is lifted. So in this paper, we have described the state of the Indian economy in the pre-COVID-19 period, assesses the potential impact of shock on various segments of the economy, analyze and policies that have been announced so far, and the Reserve Bank of India role, and government is taking some initiative for this. So we have discussed some of them, and the increasing hatred about China around the world can be a good option for India. That also we have discussed here. So for next slide, here some report collected from World Health Organization website as on 17th May 2020. As I said before, this all data is past data. It is not current data. So this can create a confusion, but this in present situation, this is many more. But as I informed that I have to present my research paper. So these data are from my research paper. So we can see that in Southeast Asia, the scenario is the COVID cases number, the death number, how was the situation, is community transmission or not. So here all the things is there. So we can see India is on top, and now top of Southeast Asia in that day. But we all know that India is in rank 7 in whole world about the positive cases of COVID-19. So these are the things we all know. So I will not say many things about this. So this from Europe and Switzerland, Sweden, Portugal, we all have this data nowadays in news. So I am not saying more things about this. This is the scenario of America. Now it crosses a huge. So this is very critical situation in both. So now I'll go for impact of COVID-19. In a simple language, I have written there that there have only two impact of COVID-19. One is good, one is bad. So somehow it is not good for any. It is not good for any way, but for environment, for behavior of humans, for opportunity of business, it can be good for our Indian society. And it's bad, it's affect everywhere, the whole system, I think, except in environment. It affects everywhere in our Indian society, or as well as world, I can say. So next, this is an example of COVID-19 effect, good effect or bad effect in a same place. So this is the demand during electricity demand during lockdown. We can see the demand. We can see the demand from 2nd March. Sorry, 2nd March to 7th April. We can see the electricity demand. So as we see that the demand is highly decreasing day by day. From 2nd March, it is like 11, and now in 7th April, it is like minus 22. So we can see the scenario of the electricity demand. But what is good and what is bad for this? So electricity come from the natural resources. So as demand is decreasing, so the production of electricity is also decreasing. We all are know. So this is good for our environment. It decreases the pollution by many how. But what is bad here? The bad here is the all the things, like every business is depend on. Every production business, every manufacturing business is depends on this electricity, I think, for sure. So as it is declining, so we can assume that the production houses is closed during this lockdown. So this is bad for our economy. That is an example of good and bad together. So for next, I have another example. Another example is air pollution indicator. The Central Pollution Control Board released this air pollution indicator. This is a indicator of 7 important cities over India, and the air pollution record from 5th February to 7th April. So we can see that this dark blue line is for 2020 in the same date, and the light blue is the for 2019 in the same date. We can see the pollution start from 2010 in 2019, and it ends like 170. And we know that the normal indicator is 100. And we can see that from 2020, 5th February, this is a huge 170 start, but it goes on 7th April and 90. And I can assume that it's a little lesser for today. So air pollution is an indicator of both industrial activity and vehicular movement. Central Pollution Control Board's air quality index for India's major 7 cities shows a significant improvement in air quality during the lockdown period. The index is almost half of the level seen at the same time last year, with higher values of that AQI suggesting lower quality of air. Okay, next, some other effects, I can say bad effects. So cargo traffic at Indian ports was down by around 5% year on year in March, while demand in India is reported to have the collapsed by almost 70%. And we all know that the situation of oil, crude oil situation all over the world. So people are giving money for buying the oil. This is amazing actually, but people can't buy. That is another amazing thing. Rail freight, which is an important indicator of economic activity, has been slowed down by 36%. And nowadays, rail is opening, but it can be a huge danger for our India, I assume. So another thing is India's aviation, tourism, and hospitality industries had already sustained maximum damage because of the COVID-19 outbreak. And after the lockdown, it is questionable to what extent they will be able to ride out this storm. The shutdown is bound to push India's fast growing aviation industry into peril and many other things, but aviation have affected a lot. They have to pay for this a lot because it's growing, but it's in danger. It was in danger also before COVID-19. Because of the loans and the payings, and government is trying to sell the Air India, that is many various things is there. So according to Consumer Pyramids Household Survey, travel and tourism accounts for 5% of total employment in India. It is nearly 20 million hotels, restaurants, account for another 4 million. So 24 million job is in danger for this COVID-19 pandemic. This is very important and very crucial thing. The lockdown associated disruption will affect agriculture activities. It affects every sector, but it affects also agricultural activities. So necessary supply chain through several channels, input distribution, harvesting, procurement, transport hurdles, marketing and processing, restriction of movement of labor scarcity may impede farming and food processing. Not may, it is for sure it will affect this. So from April, this is the peak session for rabi produce. We know all the rice production in the villages is this is the time. April is the season. So we know this. So harvesting will get hampered due to the departure of thousands of migrant workers. Shortage of fertilizer, veterinary medicines and other inputs could also affect agricultural production. So a study by Narayana 2020 indicates that farmers are stuck with harvest and agriculture product market committee. Mandis are closed in several states, thereby disrupting food supply, disruption from the production to the consumption centers. The foolishness things we can see every time, everywhere. But in this pandemic, where people can't have the money to eat, where people are very scared, in this time also there we can see some foolishness. So I want to give an example of this foolishness in this pandemic. So poultry farmers have been badly hit due to misinformation, particularly on social media, that chickens are the carriers of COVID-19. So people are believing on it and they deny to have chicken. So millions of small poultry farmers across the country, particularly in the state of Maharashtra, Karnataka, Orissa and Andhra Pradesh, are struggling after sales have crashed 80% over this false claim. I came to know from one of my friend that poultry pieces sell by 10 rupees, and that is extraordinary, unprecedented actually. So this is the thing. And one more foolish thing, foolish work during this pandemic is the attack on the COVID warriors. We have seen it in television, everywhere it is there. It was there. So that is another criminal offense also. So now I will go for migrant labor is a big issue in this pandemic. We know that all the scenario is changing for this migrant labor. I am from West Bengal and in my district there have no cases. But when the people started to come from the outside, now we are facing 100 COVID cases. One is very near to me. So that is the situation. So government can do more good things and government can handle by various good way, but they couldn't. So now migrant labor is a big issue in this pandemic. So about some bad effect of pandemic, about migrant labor is there. There are about 40 to 50 million seasonal migrant worker in India. They help in construction of urban buildings, roads, factory production and practice in several service activities. In recent days, one could see the images of hundreds of thousands of migrant workers from several states walking on foot for several hundred to go their respective village. This is the scenario for today also it is going on, but government are arranging trains, but no good thing will come from this. It can be handled in better way. So most of these migrants are now out of work as business and establishment have shut down. In the absence of money, jobs and food, savings or shelter are in large cities. So they are desperate to reach their villages. Few migrants died on the way due to extortion, lack of food, due to accident. A huge amount of migrant labor died by the accident only. So now I will come by effect on MSME. So MSME, micro, small, medium enterprises. So the micro, small, medium enterprises as a whole form a major chunk of manufacturing in India and play an important role in providing large scale employment and also in the country exports. Recent annual report MSME indicate that the sector contribute 30% and around India's GDP, and based on the conservative estimate employs around 50% of industrial workers. So here is a list. This data is showing the scenario till November 2019. We can imagine, obviously we can imagine what will be the bad effect of the pandemic, and during this time what will be the ratio. So we are seeing that non-food credit, in March it was 8.6, it is growing, but now November 2009 7.2, and it became like 4 to 5, in between 4 to 5. Industry start March is 5.6, in March 2019 it's 6.9, but November 2019 it's 2.4. But now it is this March or April, it kind 0.2 or 0.3, only pharmaceuticals are going on. So this is the scenario. This is the scenario we can see from here. So I'll go to the next page. This is the scenario of financial market and the effect till March. So we can see the blue bar is for equity and the orange bar is for debt. So we can see that October 19 November 19 December 19, what is the scenario in these 3 months, and the January, February, March. We and see this March is like lowest in equity and debt, but in April it is worst. So in April data is not there from RBI and all, so this is not here, and I will read this thing. Although all business have been affected by the pandemic, this MSME sector would be badly hit by reduced cash flows caused by nationwide lockdown. Their supply chain would be disrupted and they would be affected by the exodus of migrant worker, restriction in the availability of raw materials by the disruption to export the import, and also by the widespread travel bans, closure of malls, hotels, trades and educational institutes, etc. So this is the budget data. This the budget estimate when the government announced their budget, they estimated like this, but the actual investment is very less in this 1920, and we can see in 1819 this is equal, in 1718 is more, but in 1920 it is less. This is not a good picture for 2019 and 2020. So government during this pandemic, to maintain the things and the economy and also the society, the government have announced various things after this date. The government also announced like 20 lakh crores, as we all know, and more than recently, before one day, government allowed 20,000 crores for small businesses. So it is a huge money. government announced, but the details about 3 lakh crores is given, because in that day, till that day, the announcement is like that. So collateral free automatic loans to 3 lakh crores till 31st October 2020 with no guarantee fees, which will be benefited 55 lakhs units to resume business. So there have some past data. This is not, I think this is not so important for today's scenario. So I'll go for next page. Some policy recommendation. There have some various researcher and the economist have given some recommendation in to change the policy for surviving. So I am very glad that most of the things here we have written, most of the things are already changed and agreed by the government till today. So here some safety of farm population, supply chains, milk and poultry industry, there have some recommendation to change this policy. So till today they have this maximum things have changed. So for today's scenario, this is not so important. So I'll go for next page. This MNREGA things, I want to read this cash transfer and MNREGA, that Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. So this may have a great impact to the migrant labor as well as the poor people from villages. So as you all know that all the women's who have Jandhan account, they are getting 5,500 per month, but it is not enough for that migrant labor or that villager. So various people, various economists, various scientists and various eminent people have suggested to make 3,000 to 6,000 in between. So this is a suggestion, but government is trying, government is given 1,000, 2,000 rupees, but it is not enough for a family or for a migrant labor or villagers. And for MNREGA, it to a certain extent, the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, scheme works as an automatic stabilizer, because if people need jobs, they can just apply. The constant here is that social distancing has to be maintained due to the COVID-19 outbreak, and since economic activity will get stalled, even MNREGA may not be a viable option right now. So these are the things is going on nowadays. MNREGA in my state government and also central government is focusing on this MNREGA, and they are trying to give jobs, especially my state. Our CM is focusing on this MNREGA, and they are trying to give jobs by the daily laborers, the migrant people, by this. So this can be a good initiative, but it effects can be bad also. So I want to give a model which followed by Kerala government, and it should I think this model should followed by every state government as well as central government. Kerala government, for example, has announced 20,000 crore package. The components of the package are 2 months of welfare pension to given as an advance. All needs families get free food grains from the PDSA, subsidized meal program at risk 20 to be delivered at home. Loans over 2,000 crore will be given through Kudumbasri program, 500 crore of health packages, employment guarantee program for 3,000 crore. And this is the best model, I think. I think it is for India, this is the best model, and we have that economic condition that we can manage these things, and it will help the poor also and the migrant labor, the big issue. State That one more thing is there, one government can give a one time relaxation of the FRBM Act, that fiscal that FRBM Act considered in view of extraordinary situation. So the FRBM Act is for fiscal management act, for making the fiscal deficit lower. So this act created in 2003. So this extraordinary situation, state governments also have to incur a lot of expenses to take care of health economic crisis. Therefore, FRBM Act has to be relaxed for state governments too. The government can also make of the windfall gains emanating from the global oil price collapse. The appropriate design of the stimulus measures need to be carefully thought about. So all the things are the bad effect, and the some recommendation that can be followed to survive from this pandemic. So now the biggest question is coming about the project also and present day situation also. The question is, India, is it possible for India to revive and by itself? So here some answer is there. This is completely my opinion. There have this sorry for this inconvenience. This is completely my opinion. As I am doing my master's in business administration, I find some these things that as an opportunity. So this is COVID-19 is not expected anyhow, but COVID-19 gives a huge opportunity to India, I think so. So my answer is yes. There have a huge chance to revive Indian economy, actually more strong than before, if the government take the right decision and the right way to survive. There should have two kind of action need to take: immediate action to sustain the growth of the economy, second long term growth for Indian economy. In this immediate action, government takes a very positive role to sanction huge money for MSME sector, which is very vital for Indian economy. But I have a doubt on this, because government are giving huge money, no doubt, but I don't think that government has that infrastructure to have all money back. If the people are we can see that the scenario of banking frauds, how people are not giving the loans, and how non-performing assets are increasing day by day. Banks and government NP is increasing day by day. So this is another issue, but for now, for this situation, this is a very good initiative by government to give a huge money for the surviving for the economy. Government increase the startup allotment is a very good step for revival. Same doubt is also here. Only giving loans on credits to everyone is a great help, but government need to think more on recovery to sustain in long run business. That is the thing I want to say. Change in policies with immediate effect can create more confusion to the citizen. So it should be very clear. If it is clear to everybody, it will help. It will obviously help. India government is in the way of privatization of everything, as we came to know for recent news, which may not good for the long term, but it will helps in this pandemic, no doubts. But I don't think it will help later, when everything will be normal. People will protest against this, I wish, and I think so. Honorable Prime Minister of India said, go for local things and make local to global. So I found a word, global. This is make things to local to global. That is the things I found this word global. I give this word global. So this will make India self-confident. And this is a good news that India is increasing their export. America, like USA, is one of the top country, is our a good export member. They are expecting a huge amount of product, and huge amount of they are giving huge amount of money to us as an export. This can be a way to revive, but have a think about the raw materials we have, quality of that. That is another that is another issue. We are mostly depend on China, but because of their raw materials and their quality products. But for India, there have the lack of detailing, lack of that skill, and lack of raw materials. Good raw materials is the issue for making self-dependent India. Changes in FDI and make the law easy and tax rebate, sales rebate is another way to revive it. It revive the economy and create a good business relationship, but it may have some negative effect in long term also. India will make a strong economy when the share of the wealth will distribute among all. We know that 3% the wealth of India is distributed. The 90-100% of wealth is in hand of 3% people in India, but other 97% wealth is in other people have nothing in the sense of sense that everything is in that 3% people. So we have to concentrate in these things, in this scenario, to distribute among all. Due to COVID-19 hatred, most of the MNCs are transferring their business to other country. We can see that Vietnam is the most supported place by the MNCs. But this is the real time to show the quality of the India and to grab the people from all over world to make business, make investment in India by anyhow, because India have the manpower, India have the youth power. But the thing is, corruption and all the politics is the companies are don't want to come here. That's the thing we have to change in this situation. For that only long term we can grow a huge. Government need to take a strong action against corruption, as I said. And if government do not take strong action, corruption, very hard work, will return a big zero. This will go absolutely zero. So we have to, for long run sustain, education is the most important thing, and skill, necessary skill to grow up, the necessary skill is another important thing. We have 8-10% top class institution. Institution like IIM, IITs, NITs, so AIIMS. So these students from this institution, they are going to abroad. As we all know, most of them are going to abroad, and they are making money for the others, not for India, other country. So
hello, Pritam.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, yes.
Sorry to interrupt, but you are running out of time.
Okay, another 2 minutes I want.
Okay, within 2 minutes, please finish the presentation.
Two minutes, no problem, 2 minutes. So we have only, as I said, 8-10% top class institution to make a long run effect, to make a long run, long term effect of this. And to make a good society, to make a good business, to make a good economy, we need good education system. So instead of allotting money for that defense, lakhs crores, we should invest in healthcare and education system, so that the 100% education system is more neat and clean, and which is not for degree, which is for knowledge. So we should think about this. So this is a conclusion. So COVID-19 has posed an unprecedented challenge for India, given the large size of the population, the precious situation of the economy, especially of the financial sector. In pre-COVID-19 period, the economy's dependence on informal labor, lockdowns, and other social distancing measures would be hugely disrupted. And At the same time, the must ensure that response remain enshrined in a rules-based framework, limit exercise of this action in order to avoid long-term damages of the economy. COVID-19 can give also an opportunity to become self-dependent. Indian economy may have to face either the best or the worst due to this pandemic. That is the main line of my whole research project, I think. Okay, thank you for giving me this opportunity. I will conclude here. I will be happy to give answers.
Hello, ma'am. We can start with the question and answer.
Pritam, you said many things, covered whatever you could in this presentation, and my question is, I think I have asked the same question to many presenters before also. What is new in your presentation? What is your specific suggestion, your specific idea that you would like to tell others? Not what is happening around, or not giving information which is well known in the public, which is in the public domain already. One or two things which is your idea, which you think is must be
understood. I got your question, ma'am. So what I think is, the first thing, in this scenario, we all know that government is allowing a huge amount of money for the for surviving. But I don't think anybody is thinking about how to recover the money. How to government have not how to recover the money from those who are taking the money. So that is one thing I am thinking, that how I will work on it also, that how government or banks can take the money back. That is the scenario, and people, everybody is thinking about that nowadays, thinking about the health infrastructure. But why the health infrastructure is not here? Why Delhi government is allotting a huge money not in infrastructure and education, but not other states? So why these things is happening? This is another thing of mine. And about this migrant workers, what is the thing is going on? This is very bad. My concept is about this migrant worker. They should not send to the states. State can allocate funds. They are wasting their money by many how, but they are not. They can take care about that migrant workers. And one more thing, I think nobody is saying in this project about this, that education. That education, we should have that top class education for 100%. Then only India will survive. India can face any situation if the education, like IIMs, like IITs, is everywhere in India. As like that USA is doing like this, and they are very well educated as far we think now. But we should do like same things for India also. That only India can face any situation, any bad thing.
Okay. Hi, this is Ankita. I also have some comments on it. So basically, mainly the data source was not mentioned for any of the data that you have used. Secondly, there is no data on aviation. So you have talked about aviation sector, but there was no data as such. And I wanted to comment on one of the tables which you have used, which is non-food credit industry textile. So I was not clear what exactly the number denoted till November 2019. So please clarify on that. And you showed me the data for demand for electricity. So is it the demand for electricity or growth rate of demand for electricity, because it's going into negative? So yes, this figure also needs explanation. And one more thing, that you showed budgeted versus actual expenditure. So what was the need of this slide in this impact of COVID-19 on the Indian economy? So
oh,
these
sure,
are some
ma'am,
of
sure.
my comments.
Okay. First, I would like to clarify that electricity demand. This is absolutely demand, ma'am, because demand does not mean what we don't have. Demand always does not mean what we don't have. Demand is what you are using. What is the necessity? That is also one kind of demand. So till we can see that 2nd March, the demand is high, like 11. But after that, the necessity of the electricity is declining because of the lockdown, because of the non-industry, non-production works. So that is the thing. I think this is clear, ma'am?
Yes, yes.
Why this is necessary for this presentation? Because we are talking about Indian economy, ma'am. So we should know how Indian economy is performing. What is the capability of Indian economy? So for the basic insights, that a simple thing. It does not have some deep meaning, but somehow we should know about the disinvestment and the budget because of this. How much we can afford? For this, I have given this here. So this does not have some deep meaning, but somehow for insight, I get this.
Yeah.
Ma'am. You said two more things, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am, I forgot. Please.
Yeah. One more table in which you have given about non-food credit, industry, textile. So what does this number denote under each of the March 2015, March 2016, or November 19?
Okay, this is
there's no unit of measurement here, so
this is out of 10 Citibank research. This data is from collected from Citibank research, so they have given this data. They mark this as out of 10, 8.6. These are working, these are growing, like March 15 8.6, March 16 9.1, out of 10. And the other thing, the all data is given by out of 10. So
what is out of 10 in this, as in what is this data? That is what
I have some confusion also. I'm sorry, ma'am, for this. I need to clarify on this.
Sure. You can work up further on this.
Yeah. I need to work on this.
Okay.
Any more thing, ma'am?
No, thanks.
Okay,
no.
Thank
you. Hello, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Can we end the session?
Yes.
thank you, Pritham, and thank you, Saili, ma'am, and Ankita, ma'am.
Thank you, everyone.
Okay, thank you.